I need your advice on keep right furnace complaints. Which complaint should I actually heed when shopping for a new furnace?
One of the biggest problems with keep right furnaces is that it is hard to find someone who can fix it, and even if you can find a repairman, it is hard to get parts.
Lennox furnaces have problems finding service people outside the Northeast. It is hard to find someone to do warranty work on a Maytag furnace because their reimbursement rates are so low.
Let's say that KeepRite has poor quality parts that they still manage to make you wait to get.
That's a legitimate complaint, if you wait a long time for parts that break soon after you install them.
The burner assemblies have problems, though KeepRite is not as bad as some of its rivals at condensation that puts the burners out.
Yeah, that's a major problem with Armstrong furnaces.
KeepRite furnaces do have problems with a flue leaking water.
That means you have to clean the furnace regularly of all the ash, and maybe scrub the inside of the unit to prevent rust.
It also means you'll have to change the filters out more often to prevent excess moisture buildup due to restricted airflow as it gets clogged.
If the unit doubles the maintenance the furnace needs, that would make me complain about it too.
The fans are loud.
All fans are loud. You know the blowers are out in most units by the silence too.
KeepRite furnaces keep you up at night from the noise, and when the cool down fan turns on, it will wake you up.
That's a problem.
Another problem is that they are inefficient despite the labels, so you'll burn through more fuel to keep your house just as warm.
I've heard jokes about Rudd and American Standard being so efficient because they are not working half the time. I hate the idea of a cheaper furnace costing me more in the long run by burning more fuel.
It'll probably cost you more than a new furnace in repair parts, with fuel being an extra.
I do not need a furnace burning a hole in my wallet.
One of the biggest problems is the blowers blowing and blowing and not shutting off.
That makes more noise than anything else.
And distributes heat that keeps the furnace going unless you turn it off.
And I thought it was a bad enough complaint to have to go down into the furnace every morning to turn it on.